إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: محمد رسول الله والذين معه شداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. الله سبحانه وتعالى يشهد القرآن that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, and those who are with him very tough with the disbelievers. شداوا على الكفار رحماء merciful with each other, with the believers. This is a great ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the companions, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said: خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. The best people, my generation. The best people or the best generation is my generation, the companions. Then next to them the تابعين. Then next to them تابع التابعين. And there are many آيات and أحاديث about the virtues of companions رضي الله تعالى عنهم. And no doubt that the companions are the best people رضي الله تعالى عنهم after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they convey the religion to us. Without the companions, no religion. And one of the best companions, عثمان بن عفان. We should know who is عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنهم. عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى one of the Muslims who accepted Islam at the beginning of da'wah when it was very difficult, when it was risky to accept Islam in Mecca. He accepted Islam before Umar al-Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنه. At the beginning of the da'wah, the few days of da'wah, he accepted Islam, عثمان بن عفان. Uthman bin Affan is called Dun Nurayn, the two lights, the person of two lights, which means the scholars explain that he married two daughters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course, not together. At the beginning, Ruqayya, then she passed away radiallahu ta'ala anha, then he married Umm Kulthum. And some scholars say no one from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and from the previous prophets had two daughters of a prophet except Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He got the honor of marrying two daughters of a prophet and the best prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uthman ibn Affan is a person in paradise, clearly said by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr will be in paradise. Umar will be in paradise. Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. Uthman will be in paradise. Fil Jannah, he is in Jannah. Then he mentioned the Prophet ﷺ, the other 10 companions. Ali, Talha, Zubayr, Sa'd, Abd al-Rahman, Awf, Sa'id, Zayd, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. He is in paradise. Without any discussion, without any doubt. One of the believers. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day with 1,000 dinar, not our dinar, 1,000 dinar, which means of gold. 1,000 dinar of gold, which means every dinar about 4.25 grams of gold. And more than 4,000 grams of gold. How much? 4,000 grams of gold. One day he took this much of money. He went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The 1,000 of gold and his garment. And that was in the ninth year. في غزوة تبوك. غزوة العسرة, the distress. It was very difficult. The enemy was very strong. Far away from Medina. So he took in his garment 1,000 dinar of gold. عليه رضي الله تعالى عنه. He went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he poured this gold, this 1,000 dinar of gold, in the lap of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. عبد الرحمن رضي الله تعالى عنه said, I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم turning them over in his lap. Very happy. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Saying, Ma darra Uthman ma amila ba'da al-yawm. Ma darra Uthman ma amila ba'da al-yawm. He repeated twice. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uthman does after today will not harm him. Whatever Uthman does after today will not harm him. This is only one incident. Only one incident he did that, radiallahu ta'ala, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him like a stamp. Whatever you do, you are forgiven. Doesn't mean go and do sins. You will not do the sins, radiallahu ta'ala. But this is a purification from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to this great man, Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying in bed in the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and with his thigh uncovered. He was at home sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is normal. He was with his wife. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anha came in to visit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Always he visits the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the closest friend, Abu Bakr. So when he entered, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not change his position and he had the conversation with Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu left. Umar came in. The same thing, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not change his position. He was lying down sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course it doesn't mean he doesn't respect them. But it means he's okay with one of the closest friends, Umar, Abu Bakr, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But when Uthman came in, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat down and he set right his clothes. He covered his thigh sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he changed his position. Then Uthman radiallahu ta'ala discussed with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some issues. Then he left. Aisha said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr entered and you did not stir and did not observe much care. Then Umar, no change in your position. But when you saw Uthman enter in the house, you did what you did. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ala astahi min rajul tastahi minhu al malaika. Should I not show modesty to one whom even the angels show modesty? Allahu Akbar.
The angels?
Yes, the angels.
We don't see them, but they can't see us. Who? Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. One day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam climbed or ascended the mountain of Uhud, the great mountain, Jabal. يُحِبُّنَا وَنُحِبُّهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Uhud, it's a mountain. We love him. And he loves us. He loves the companions. He loves the believers. And it is a stone. While you find some of the human beings, they have hearts and they hate the companions. Their hearts are harder than the stones. Subhanallah. Uhud, Jabal, يُحِبُّنَا وَنُحِبُّهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman were on that Mount Uhud radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Then the Mount Uhud shook beneath them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hit on the mountain and he said, Uthbut Uhud. O Uhud, be firm, for on you there is none but a prophet, a siddiq, and shaheed. Who was there? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Siddiq, truthful, Abu Bakr, shaheed, martyr, Umar and Uthman, radiyallahu ta'ala, anhuma, qul ma tasma'un, astaghfirullah. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه. أما بعد، عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه، one of the greatest companions. He is the third companion. أبو بكر number one. عمر number two. عثمان number three. No doubt. It was very common among the companions. When they were discussing, who's the best? Abu Bakr. Next one, Umar. Next to Umar, Uthman. No discussion. It was clear for all of them that Uthman is the third man. Radiyallahu ta'ala. And he was the third Khalifa for the Muslim Ummah, the third ruler for the Muslim Ummah. Very clear for them. And this did not cause any enmity among them. No hate because of this order and the companion among the companions of Allah Ta'ala. And why? Because they know this is from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a hadith, Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala was killed. This is there in the tariq, in the history. He was killed. Innocent, radiyallahu ta'ala. Before they killed him, the Khawarij, he looked out at them and said, call for me your two companions who incited you against me because of the rumors. Because people listen to anything. Be careful, don't listen to anything. Don't believe anything. No doubt you will accept the false information. So this was wise of it. And some people, ignorant people, believed what was against Uthman and he was innocent, radiyallahu ta'ala. He called them, he was discussing them, Uthman, radiyallahu ta'ala. They were called for him and he said, I adjure you by Allah. Do you know that when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, the masjid got too crowded for its people. And he said, who will buy this piece of land with his own wealth and use it like the rest of the Muslims? And he will have something better than it in paradise. So I bought it. Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. He bought the land. رضي الله تعالى عنه. And also a rumor, a well called rumor. The same thing. Who can buy this well for the Muslims to donate it for Muslims? And he will get something better in paradise. Uthman said, I bought it. And the third one, من يجهز جيش العسرة. He said, do you know that I am the one who equipped the army of hardship? They said, by Allah, yes. All these virtues, wallahi, one of them is enough. But there were many virtues for Uthman ibn Affan. رضي الله تعالى عنه صاحب النورين, the husband of the two lights, the two daughters of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين, وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى, ارزقهم البطانة الصالحة. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أبعد عنا الحروب, اللهم أبعد عنا القلاقل والزلازل والأوبئة يا رب العالمين. احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات من المعاكسات ومن الزنا من الخمور يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا, اللهم عاف مبتلانا, اللهم انصر اخوان المسلمين في كل مكان, وتقبل منا الصلاة, وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.